Happy Hollow Week, everyone! My name is Terry, and if you have never been to my channel before, welcome! I talk about miniature gaming, and that includes games like Zombicide, one of my favorite games to play around this time of year, for obvious reasons. Today I'm going to show you how to paint some of the models in this set, specifically the zombies, using the Army Painter paint set that you can buy very easily. It's a wonderful paint set, has everything you need to get going, so we're just going to get rolling right away and start painting up a fatty right now! So I've already prepped this model with a base coat. You can use zombie skin out of the set and you will get the same exact result as you see here as the base. I'm going to start with some dirt splatter and we're going to put it on the shoes and gloves of this fatty here. I'm going to pull a Bob Ross and pick colors that make me happy to paint, and I encourage you to do the same. You don't have to stick to what I'm doing here. I want to just show you some really basic techniques. Once the brown has been put on, I'm going to let that dry, and I'm going to throw on some waist jean, which is a blue, out of the set, and apply it to the jumpsuit on this fatty. I'm going to leave a little bit of the top part not blue, because I'm going to actually mix a little bit of the brain matter beige into this blue, and paint that so it looks like the insides kind of have rolled out of the jumpsuit near the top. You'll notice that there is a little bit of accessories on the leg of this model. I'm not going to paint that. I'm going to put some blue on it all the way up to the edge. I'm not going to try to avoid it. I can always put color on top of where I put the blue, and that's how we're going to go with that. Put paint where you feel fit, and you can always clean up the paint or touch it up later. Just apply the paint on and you can paint over it after the fact. Once we've applied that light blue shade on, I'm going to put that brain matter beige straight up onto the tank top of the fatty here. And I'm going to take a little bit of filthy suit and actually put that color onto the accessories on the pants and mix a little bit of the dead black from the set into it and paint the gas mask around this fatty's neck. So we have this model all base coated up. Now the next step is adding the zombie shader out of the set onto the model. I do not dilute it, unlike the paints, which you should dilute to probably 1-to-1 ratio with water. The zombie shader I put on straight, and just to make sure it doesn't pile up, put thin layers on and just make sure you cover the entire model. It's really easy and it really settles in the cracks and gives you a really great shaded effect. You can see it right here. The final step is to add the blood. I'm using the two blood tones in the set, Glistening Blood and Crusted Sore. I'm going to water down the Glistening Blood past 1-to-1. It's probably 1-to-3 with water, so you get this really runny tone and it's actually quite transparent. And I'm going to apply it all over the front and chest. I'm going to try to pick up the paint as well so it doesn't puddle up too much, because I want this to look like it's kind of spread and been rubbed out. And then throw on a few dots of Crusted Sore. It's this really dark, almost purple red. Apply it up into the mouth so it looks like he's had some fresh kill inside of there, as well as put some splatter and little dots across his front so it looks like there's been blood spray. It really adds that extra dramatic effect and finishes this model off beautifully.
Alright, now that was pretty easy, but just to make sure that you get the best outcome for your paint job, I'm going to give you a few hints. Hint number one, wash your models before you actually put any paint on them. Take some dish soap, some hot water, and an old toothbrush, and give them a scrub and a rinse. The reason why you do that is because these models are coated with release agent to get them out of the mold that they come in, and that release agent actually prevents paint from sticking to the model. So by doing that, you ensure that the paint will actually stick and not chip off, and it makes it really easy to paint later on. The second thing to help the paint stick on and help the actual base coat of it is to get a primer. This is Army Painter Skeleton Bone. It's what I used to prime the fatty that I just painted for you today. Very, very easy to do. This can is less than $20, and you can do like all the models in the box and then probably a couple of the expansions with one can. So it's a really great investment. If you're not into getting the primer, you can, provided you wash the model, use a zombie skin in the paint set to base coat them. It is actually the same color as the skeleton bone, so it's a good way to go that way as well. Finally, if you have one on hand, a hairdryer will help your models dry just a little bit faster. If you're doing specific batches, which I highly recommend if you're doing a lot of zombies at the same time, using a hairdryer with a cool setting, like this one right here, will make sure that your paint will dry. It doesn't move around too much, but it makes sure that you have nice dry coats to work on top of. You don't want to put one single thick coat of paint on it and then try to paint over it, because usually that ends up with really splotchy results. Thin layers dried in between will give you a far better result in the end. Here's a special shout out to Cameron from the Tabletop Fan Community on Google+, who shared this beautiful photo of his set of Zombicide models he painted up. Now in vlogs like these, as well as vlogs on the Geek and Sundry Vlogs channel, I love featuring painted projects from you. So if you want to send them to me, you can send them to me in the links down below via social media. Let me know in the comments below what tabletop games you'll be playing this Halloween. And while you are down there, don't forget to hit the like button to like this video and subscribe to my personal channel. I'll be posting more videos this entire week with wonderful Halloween-y themes, so do check back in. Until next time, I will see you soon.
I think I made a mistake. Maybe I should just go back to the dorm.
Vamps are real. They own Morganville, but you're safe with us.